Hey guys, it's markabusi here and I'm back with another reaction video, and this time we're going to be doing Big Love by Lindsay Buckingham, who was the guitarist for Fleetwood Mac. Back when I was wee, my dad used to, when he did play music, he used to play it at full volume so that it was fucking shake around the entire house. And he really only ever used to play like two bands. He'd play Fleetwood Mac constantly and he'd play ABBA, but whenever he played Fleetwood Mac it was usually like a live video that he had of them playing from the Tusk tour. I'm talking that I was like 5-6 at the time, and he'd go, Mark, come in. I'd go in and they'd be playing the intro to Tusk. It'd be Mick Fleetwood on the drums doing that really fucking cool drum beat, and then like monster would come on the stage and run about, and he'd be like, oh, there comes the monster, and I'd be like, no, the monster, and I'd run away. And he thought that was hilarious because my dad was a fucking psycho. That made me not keen on Fleetwood Mac for about the first 25 years of my life. Then one day I listened to The Chain and I was like, oh, that song is fucking incredible. Anyway, long story short, there was a guy on TikTok today who was doing a cover of Never Coming Back Again, I think that's the name of it, and he was saying that was an amazing guitar line, and everybody was then in the comments going, you think that's an amazing guitar line, you should hear Big Love. And I, off the top of my head, don't actually know Big Love, so I thought I'm going to check that out, because if the guitar line for that is better than the guitar line for Never Going Back Again, or Never Come, whatever that song is, then it must be an excellent guitar line. So yeah, that's the preamble. This is Lindsay Buckingham live playing Big Love. That's one guitar. Oh, damn. That seems like two guitars. It seems like you've got one that's doing like a pick on a basic chord, and then one that's doing the thing, but the melody line. But looking at it, it's not. It's one guitar. Well, I mean, it's one guitar. Looking out for love. Oh, how build you kingdom in their house on the hill. How in the hell is he managing to sing and play at the same time? Like that, I mean, I don't mean sing and play at the same time. Loads of folk can do that, but how is he managing to do that? I love that man's voice. It's a shame that Lindsay Buckingham, I suspect, is a bit of a prick. Right. Short history lesson for the folk that don't know. So, Fleetwood Mac was originally Mick Fleetwood, Peter Green, and I think someone else, I'm not sure who else, and I think then John and Christine McVie joined. I could be wrong about the timelines of stuff, but basically at some point they said we should probably get another guitarist and singer in, and Lindsay Buckingham had just released an album with Stevie Nicks, who I'm pretty sure was his wife at that point. And they were like, oh, Lindsay, do you want to come in and join Fleetwood Mac? And he went, only if I'm allowed to bring Stevie Nicks. And they said yes. And then it just went to absolute shit. And I think they broke up at the time that they were writing rumors, which is why the chain is all about them breaking up. Amongst almost every song in that album is about one of the members of the band breaking up with another member of the band, because they were all breaking up. I think Mick Fleetwood was fucking Christine McVie, who's John McVie's wife, but they had broken up. It was a whole thing. But then they settled the differences and he joined the band again years later, and then they kicked him out, and then he joined again and they kicked him out, and now they vowed that he's never joining the band ever again. So it's a whole thing. But man, the guy is talented. Thing is, right, it's not even that he's managing to sing and play that at the same time, which is impressive, although it is, right? It's the fact that that guitar line is ridiculously complex. If you listen to the singing, he's got like a really nice kind of vibrato going in that last note, which is not easy to do, especially if you're concentrating on what you're doing with the guitar. There, right at the end.
Beautiful.
He's actually like soloing whilst playing the fucking song on the one guitar. That's insane. I'm taking that back. That's astonishing. Listen, this entire part with the singing is astonishing. Fucking nuts. Okay. I mean, what do you even say to that? That was insane. It turns out when he got to the chorus, I did kind of recognize the song. I have heard it before. I just completely forgot it even existed. I did not realize that entire damn thing was just him on a guitar, just going wild. At one point, it's like he's playing three different guitar parts. That's fucking mental. I don't really have much to say to that other than that was absolutely stunning. What is your guys' favourite Fleetwood Mac song? Is there any guitarists that you think are better than that? And if there is, put them in the comment below. Let me know. Anyway, thank you guys for watching.